Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. Alright guys, so I am officially on Heroic 7 and looks like we're gonna finish Heroic 7 in this solo raid run itself from my main account. So yeah, we're gonna take down a tier 2 main boss, tier 1 main boss, I'm sorry, which is Dr. Fate today. So yeah, I've actually also tried a different team over here, which we're gonna take a look in the next fight right after this one. So first fight is against Speed Force the Flash. Okay, so obviously Twin Blade on King, Gemstone on Raven, and again another Twin Blade, which is at level 1 on Dr. Fate. All right. Decent start. Let's hope that the end as well as end is also as good as the start. All right, unhittable, no problems over there. Three stacks each. Oh no. So yeah, the thing we need to be careful about is that he can stun with the specials. Can pretty much get you into a stun loop every time he does a special attack on you. Yeah, I need to get those stacks for Gemstone. The moment I actually upgraded my Twin Blade to level 7, I can see the difference in the damage. So the damage went from 220 to 240. That's 20% increased damage that I'm getting on armor-pierced attacks. And I can see the difference clearly, which is a good thing actually. Now I used to have some issues sometimes to one-shot bosses with this team. Let's hope we can do it this time. I mean, yeah, there is a clear difference in the damage, and we just have three stacks of gemstone and die. Okay, not bad. Can we maintain the stacks? Nope. It's gone. That was a mistake. That was a terrible mistake. And this is exactly what I was talking about, a stun loop. I'm going to lose all the stacks.
Lightning fast.
Luckily, not the stacks for darkness.
Remember, don't blink.
Okay. Come on, dude. Just 10 seconds. This is not going to be enough. Did somehow maintain that stack of darkness to one, and that's it. All right guys, so I mean, I can clearly see the difference in the damage. It's just that I was into that little stupid stun loop. But now this is the team that I was talking about. I never really used Gemstone with Mr. Freeze, so we're gonna go with Gemstone on Zatanna, Mr. Freeze with obviously Zatanna's puppet, and the Twin Blade on John Stewart Green Lantern. So let's see how this works. So this is obviously the first time that I'm using this team. So what we need in order to activate gemstone stacks is that your combo meter should be more than 26 hits, and we can easily get that actually if I simply use Zatanna, because gemstone just does not increase the damage, it also increases the combo meter by giving you extra hits. I see 16 hits already, and there we go, he's burning, and that's the second stack. Yeah, third stack. Let's see if the damage has increased or not. Okay, And it has actually, as a matter of fact, because normally I used to get around 30. Oh, why did it not work over there? I'm not sure. But let's do it again. That was not 26 hits. Can't complain about that. We got 300% damage buff from Zatanna. There we go. No stun. Surprisingly, he resisted all the stuns. Mr. Freeze. Okay, alright, so are we getting increased damage? Not as expected, to be honest. Now we can see it should be like around 200-300k. That will be much better, you know, if you're gonna use this team. It's gone over 100k. He's blind. There we go. It's definitely gone over 100k now. 140, close to 140. And okay. Alright, so this may not be an optimal way, to be honest, to use this particular team. But I'm going to try to find a way to use Gemstone. And use it with Mr. Freeze, actually, because that is important, because Mr. Freeze is doing nothing, just sitting there in the roster. So yeah, if you guys have any good suggestions or any creative suggestions, do let me know down in the comments, and I'll be more than happy to try out that team next. Let's do this. This should be easy. Obviously, it's easy with the metal team. All right, good job. So now I've actually used all the three characters, all the three metal characters before Robin King and Batman Who Laughs plus Batwoman the Drowned. And I've actually done a one-shot, a 1.9 billion one-shot, which kind of worked actually pretty well, but I really don't want to. I'm going to try to get some gears on Robin, see if that would increase it. That will increase the damage a little bit, yes. Not a little bit, actually more than that, depending on how many gears I have. Okay, there we go. Sacrificing. Not exactly sacrificing, she's still alive. I didn't do the super move over there because we only have like half the power, darkness power meter filled. So there was no point in doing a super move. Oh, we can do the super move. Yep. And sometimes, much better way is just to swipe back. There we go. I still had a lot of time left. And this was good. Definitely good. Now the main boss, which is not that difficult at all. It's going to be boss Dr. Fate. Only two hits, will it last longer? Nope. They're gone. Okie dokie, come on dude. Give me more damage. Yes, it's time to do the super move now. So, to be honest, there is not really any point in trying, you know, anything else with this team, like, improvising. Because we are doing these 1 billion one-shots, 2 billion one-shots quite easily with this setup. There is no need to change it. But maybe I'll try some different teams over here, you know. Maybe on my, you know, new account, a second account too, Void Live, which is, because I think I'm almost, I have almost completed all the solo rage till Heroic 7, you know. This is just one of those few solo raids which I have not completed Heroic 7 on. Alright, time to die. There we go. It's still 1 minute and 4 seconds left. Now let's hope the rewards are as good as this pip. I think my league raid is also completed, so we'll have some of those rewards too. Alright, come on, give me a solo raid artifact. Hush, actually, not bad. And the reason why I say not bad is not because of the character, because it's a rare character, actually. It doesn't drop that easily, for me at least, you know, and the solo raid drops. Alright, so an Azure artifact, a couple of Azure artifacts, one from, obviously, from the League Raid. Alright, so Robin over here is resilient, which means that I obviously need to use Dark Metal cards. That's exactly what we're going to do. You know, in order to tackle this resilient situation, I think this is a pretty good team. There are many other options that you can use if you don't have the gemstone. You can go with Raven, you can put the Solo Raid artifact on Raven. You know, Dark Metal cards on Harley Quinn and another Solo Raid artifact, or maybe a Region Matrix on EPI. You can also use Zatanna. You know, use Zatanna with Zatanna's Puppet, and then you can go with EPI with the Solo Raid artifact, and you can go with obviously Dark Metal cards on Harley Quinn. This is just one of those teams that I'm using, and the reason why is that it leaves Raven out. With this team, I can use Raven with and Zatanna with the different teams, and it gives me more option. Die. Dead. Okay. Ah, good job. All right, guys, and let's move on to the final pip. And I'm gonna go with my boss and his damage dealers against Starfire. Power Girl. You know, with King, I don't know if you guys have seen that pip before, but I've used all three damage dealers once. And that was a good pip, actually. I did more than 1.5 billion damage. It was like 1.53 billion, something like that. It was good, but it just gave me 100 million extra damage. You basically cannot really one-shot your opponents with these percentage damage dealers. That's the only thing. So maybe I think two damage dealers and one support character is a much better choice. Using three damage dealers at times when one of your damage dealer percentage damage dealers, when at time if they die pretty quick or they don't do the damage you're looking for, then maybe the third character comes in. But if all your damage dealers, if first two main percentage damage dealers, like I don't have King over here, right? So if these two do the job, then I probably won't even use King. And even if I use King, it won't give me like an extra 200 or 300 million, maybe 100, maybe 150 at the max. Extra damage, and I'm talking about 150 million. That's it. Oops, I'm dead. Yeah, I need to get her in the corner. Yeah, otherwise she will keep killing me and the clones will die. And we pretty much won't be able to do anything about it. That was lucky. What I did over there is I just held block. And the moment she did start the basics, I just clicked on special 2. And yeah, obviously she's easily combo interruptible, so that's gonna help a lot. And maybe next time I'll try to use gemstone with the Batman Ninja team. I used gemstone with Batman Ninja Catwoman. I have never used gemstone with Batman Ninja Batman. Maybe we'll give that a try tomorrow. Going great. And now the percentage damage is, I think I do have a few hits left on Deathstroke. Yeah, that's good. And it's done. Anyways, just 20 seconds were left. Alright guys, so yeah, I guess that is it for today's video. If you enjoyed it, give it a like and let's meet again in the next video. Thank you very much guys. Bye-bye.